Okay, this is going to be a problem about an elastic. So this is going to be an elastic collision. So it's going to be in elastic collision. And in this one, in the inelastic collision, kinetic energy is not conserved. So the kinetic energy before and the kinetic energy after the collision is going to be different. So it's not conserved. Kinetic energy is not conserved. So to solve this problem, we're going to use two ideas. We're going to use conservation of momentum. Conservation of momentum. And we're going to use conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. And the problem is the following. We have here is the ceiling, and we have a particle here. Let's say it's a piece of wood that has mass M. It has mass M, big M. And then you fire a bullet right here, a little bullet with mass little m. So little m is the mass of the bullet. And big M is the mass of the block. It's a block of wood. And what's going to happen in this case is the bullet is going to hit, it's going to hit the block, and then the bullet is going to stay inside. The bullet is going to stay inside the block. And together, they're going to go this way. So they're going to go like this way over here. And the bullet is going to be inside here. So we're going to have here height right here from this point right here. Let's put it from here. So this is going to be a height. And then when it gets to this height, the system of little mass plus big mass is going to stop, and it's going to acquire potential energy. So to solve this problem, we're going to use two concepts, with the concept of conservation of momentum and the conservation of energy. So what do we have? So before the collision, because it's going to be a collision, inelastic collision, we have a little m and initial velocity, which is the velocity of the bullet, let's say VO, the velocity of the bullet. And the bullet is going to follow this path, and it's going to be embedded inside the big mass, which is the piece of wood. And then they're going to go together. They're going to go together this way, and they're going to acquire potential energy. So it's going to be kind of like a pendulum. So they call it the ballistic pendulum, ballistic pendulum, the ballistic pendulum. And they call it the ballistic pendulum because it resembles a pendulum right there. So it's going to go back and forth. So little m VO plus big M velocity, initial velocity of the block is equal to little m plus big M, because now they're going to go together, V prime. V prime is going to be the velocity of the two masses after the collision, because after the collision, they're going to go together. They're going to be displaced together this way right here. So that's the first equation that we have. Let's say that's equation number one. Let's call it equation number one. And then we have another equation, which is equation number two, which is one half of little m plus big M V prime to the square, which is the kinetic energy after the collision. It's going to be equal to m little m plus big M GH, which is the potential energy, the total potential energy that is converted from this kinetic energy right here. This kinetic energy turns into potential energy. So this term is going to be zero, because the velocity of the block before the collision is zero. So V is going to be zero because he's not moving. he's going to start moving after the collision, and they're going to start moving together, the little mass and the big mass. So we have this equation right here. So we have that MVO is going to be equal to little m plus big M V prime. So VO is the velocity, the initial velocity of the bullet. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for the initial velocity of the bullet. It's going to be divided by M plus big M, and this is going to be V prime. So we got this this nice equation for V prime, which is the velocity of the two particles after the collision, And now let's go to the second equation. Let's go to equation number two. So we have here, we'll do it over here. We have here that 1/2 of little m plus big M. And now we have V prime to the square, but V prime is this right here. V prime is little MVO over little m plus big M. So it's going to be little MVO over little m plus big M, which is the mass of the block, and little m is the mass of the bullet. And this has to be to the square because it's a velocity right here. It's a velocity prime, but it's a velocity to the square. It's right here. We're doing this one right here, V prime to the square, and this is V prime. And this is equal to little m plus big M, and this is going to be GH right there. Okay, let's make a better looking G here. So this is going to be G. Okay, so so you can cancel, you can go ahead and cancel some terms. This term can be canceled with this one over here. So you got 1/2 of M to the square, VO to the square over little M plus big M to the square. You got to square everybody inside the brackets. And that's going to be GH. So you're going to send the two upstairs. So you have that VO to the square is going to be equal to 2GH times M little m plus big M to the square divided by M to the square. And then you can get rid of the, you can get rid of the square by getting the square root of everybody. So this is going to cancel with this guy. So VO is going to be, you can pull out little m plus m to the square out of the square root. So it's going to come m plus little m plus big M. And then you can pull out the little m to the square. So it's going to come like that. And you're going to multiply times the square root of 2GH. And there you go. Now you have a formula to calculate the initial velocity of the bullet. This is the initial velocity of your bullet. It's little m plus big M divided by little m times the square root of 2GH. And as you can see, well, this is an inelastic collision where the kinetic energy is not conserved, and all the energy has been converted into potential energy. Okay, so there you go. And you have another problem. Thank you.